Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
Welcome everyone to our October 19th meeting of the Alamance County Commissioners. This time I ask the Vice Chair Boswell to lead us in our invocation.
Let's bow our heads, please. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for all the blessings you give us. Thank you for this great country we live in, and thank you for the freedoms that we all share. God, we just ask that you protect our men abroad as they go and protect and give us these freedoms. And be with our local law enforcement as they're out every day working to try to secure this country. And God, just be with us tonight as we go through this meeting to do what is right for Alamance County. These things we ask in your name. Amen.
Amen. Please stand for our prayer, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Please be seated. All right. We have three public speakers that have signed up tonight. The first is Mr. Tony Cox.
I sure wish I had all them freedoms that you were praying about over there. Must be nice. First Amendment, get throwed out. Second Amendment, can't defend myself. Can't get a fair trial. Can't get charged with stuff. But I see that our schools are bringing in the next round of idiots. Failing. But we need to fill up the jails and the prisons to keep it going. They won't know their rights. This afternoon before coming here, I seen President Obama at an Oklahoma federal prison with some inmates. And they were talking about the stories of how the prosecutors threatening to give them life sentences and 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, if they didn't take the pleas. I think they said 97% of the federal cases are pleaded out. That leaves 3%. I was one of the 3%, and I couldn't get a fair trial there either. They had to lie. But hey, it's okay. If I had a bunch of money and my adopted daddy or brothers in this country held the purse strings, I guess maybe I could get me some justice, but I'm just like the rest of the poor ones. They say it only happens to minorities, but that's not true. We see it all over the place, but don't matter. It's just take it. Government comes in and tells us what religion, in God we trust, liberty and justice for all. It's a sham. It is a sham. But did anybody get any complaints about explosions in the northern part of the county this weekend?
No, but I heard it at church.
There were explosions. But I've heard them talked about here before. I don't know if it's the same explosions or not, but I know I heard them good. And so I ain't had a chance to ask none of the neighbors, though. But I get around to it because people love to talk. Love to talk. Just like me. But I talk for a reason. I'm just like Terry Johnson here. I want justice. I want it. And so I've said this before. He must have them feds as mad at him as the county commissioners have been at me over the years. But hey, I just keep laughing about it and keep going. Other people panic. But
thank you.
Thank you, Tony.
Mr. Scott. Next we have Pam Thompson, our chairman of the school board. Welcome.
Thank you. That's who I am.
I'm not used to being on this side. It's kind of nice. Last year in October, I attended the Juvenile Justice Symposium in Greensboro. I used to work with at-risk kids for many years, and I was fortunate to meet two very special gentlemen, Anthony Danino and Jim Barbie. Anthony is a motivational speaker out of Charlotte, North Carolina, and the creator of a youth development program. Jim serves as coordinator for the North Carolina Youth Violence Prevention Center through UNC Chapel Hill, which is the only center in the entire country addressing rural youth violence. In 2013, Jim created Robeson County Teen Court and Youth Services, and previously played a big part in the creation of Teen Court here in Alamance County. Robeson County has so much poverty, and it also has the highest juvenile crime rate in our state. Together, they have created the CORE project, which stands for Creating Our Reality. We talked and I asked them if this project could be written for in-school prevention services, and they said yes. I got them to come to Burlington, and we sat down with leadership at ABSS, and it was approved for Ray Street Academy, which is our alternative school for young people who have made some bad choices and unsafe decisions. Pulling these kids out of their regular school based on unsafe choices is the right thing to do, but they need more than just academics. These young people need building from the inside out and the ability to understand why they make the choices they do, because if not, this will become their life pattern and they will keep making poor choices and possibly end up in our prison system. That is unacceptable. After participating in this 7 to 10 week program, when kids do return back to their home school, they will make better choices based on skills, empowerment, support, and encouragement they have learned. They believe in themselves and they know they matter. Not every young person has a solid home with a loving set of parents, and that's our problem. Kids are not born violent, but being around violence flattens them. Violence becomes their normal. Many times the home is broken, broken homes produce broken kids, and they go to school and make bad choices. Our training was last Wednesday and Thursday with the amazing staff of Ray Street Academy and two of the finest SROs from Southern Middle and Clover Garden. What a group of people I was honored to be around. I hope this program can become part of all schools to serve as prevention for those who are illustrating the beginnings of this same at-risk behavior. Prevention is much cheaper than intervention. Kids are savable, especially if the very ones trying to save them believe that, and at Ray Street they do. And so do our school resource officers of all of our ABSS schools. It's all about teamwork. The reason I'm telling you about this is my friend Sheriff Terry Johnson funded this program for ABSS because of his sincere commitment to children. Once asked, he never hesitated to be there for us. We wouldn't have this without him, and I wanted to thank him personally and publicly. There are so many positive and life-changing things that he does for our young people that people don't know about. He has the heart of a true servant. Anytime I've ever gone to him, he's always there because he knew it would be about saving children. I cannot thank him enough. Alamance County works so well together because we get ourselves out of the way and we focus on what's important. The County Commissioner Board and our ABSS Board have seen the fruits of working together concerning our schools. We have a genuine relationship that is based on trust. I'm thankful for each one of you. Our kids are so important because our kids are the future. They
thank
must
you,
be
Thomas.
Safe.
Thank
Sorry.
You.
Thank you.
That's okay.
That
thank
okay.
you, man. We appreciate
Very
it.
Good.
Thank you. Thank you, Sheriff.
Yes, sir.
Job well done. All right, next we have Carrie Thiel. Is it Thiel?
Thiel, yes.
Carrie, come on up. I should have known that. I apologize.
You're still looking for a board member, right, Carrie?
Yes, I'm Carrie Thiel, and I'm the executive director with Alamance Partnership for Children. Thank you for letting me speak to you tonight. I'm here as sort of a FYI to let the county commissioners know that our Dolly Parton Imagination Library has now gone countywide. This is a program that the partnership has been sponsoring since about 2006. It allows each child between the ages of birth up to their fifth birthday to receive a free book in the mail every month. So we were in a position where we couldn't fund the entire county. We were only funding about a third of our elementary school districts. Through a grant with Impact Alamance, we are now able to fund the entire county. I just want the commissioners to understand that this is a huge reflection on our county, that people care enough to support our young children, especially when we have such an issue with our third grade reading scores here in the county. We want all children to begin school and be ready the first day of kindergarten. So that means having experiences with books, getting their parents to read with them, That's very important for their success. So just to let everyone know, we have experienced a 50% increase in our enrollment in about a month's time. So it's going gangbusters. We have the support of course, Impact Alamance, Department of Social Services, thank you, Susan, and the Health Department, and thank you, Stacy. We were approached by Chief Smythe with the Police Department, who has asked us for enrollment forms. He's going to make sure all of his officers, when they're out in the field, are enrolling children. So a lot of this was very unsolicited. It's great to see. We were also approached by Burlington Pediatrics and Kernodle. They will make sure that every child in the hospital, every infant born, receives an enrollment form, not just giving it to the parents, but making sure it's filled out and those children start at birth to receive books at home. So a great reflection on our county that we care, and we're going to let everyone know that we're a Dolly Parton community, and it's a good place to live because we care about children. In the state of Tennessee, every child receives Dolly Parton Imagination Library. So hopefully our goal here in North Carolina is to be that good and to care about all of our children. So thank you.
Very good, Karen.
Thank you, ma'am. Appreciate it. All right, commissioners' responses to any of our public speakers tonight.
Well, I haven't been on Carrie's board there. I know they work awfully hard out there in Glencoe to help our children here to get a good head start, and really proud of what they're doing. And maybe, like you said, Alamance is number one on the list of counties. Maybe the rest to follow our lead. So
I think it's great to hear the good work going on here, and I appreciate what the sheriff has done with the kids. And Pam, thanks for coming and explaining that and explaining the program. Very good.
Yeah.
Any comments? Our sheriff has always been had a big heart for the children in this county. There's a lot of things that he has done nobody knows about, yeah. And he wouldn't even want me to start mentioning them right now. money that he's given to different that's groups, right. And athletes, youngsters that have had the equipment that they needed because he had the heart to donate the money, and we appreciate you, Sheriff. Thank you.
I've been on some of these boards too, then I get off and then I'll go back. You run out of time sometimes and you just can't do everything. But I appreciate everything that everybody's done for the county.
And thank you, Carrie. Appreciate it. All right, next we have the approval of the agenda. Do I have a motion for approval of the agenda?
Mr. Chairman, if I could have one thing additional, and yes. I apologize for leaving it off. After our first presentation, if we could have a second presentation of our quarterly SOAR winner, who is Tampa Enoch Reese. She's here tonight, and MJ will do the introduction of her, if that's okay.
All right. Hearing that, do I have a motion to approval of the agenda as amended with the addition of the quarterly SOAR winner?
So moved.
Second.
The second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. All right. Do have it approved. I'm going to walk down for this next presentation,
yeah.
If I may. Excuse me.
We didn't do our consent agenda.
Right here, if you would, please. I'm going to talk about you for a few minutes, if I may.
That's all right. It's a pleasure to be among such distinguished people tonight.
Bless your heart. And for many years, Ms. Willie McCurran and I have had the opportunity to cross each other's paths as she worked very diligently for the senior citizens in this county and this state. And let me say this, the quality of life for our seniors in Alamance County and the state are better because of this lady sitting right here.
I love her.
I know you do. And you have done so much to improve the quality of life and make the quality of life better for all of us if we're entering our senior years and those that are in their senior years now. And God bless you, and I just can't appreciate you more. But we have something for you, our commissioners.
Oh, dear.
And but before I read it, I would just want to ask our commissioners if they have any comments tonight.
Well, Ms. Willie Mae, you have been a vocal help to seniors across this state, because I know you probably ran into him down in Raleigh, and he was a legislator, and you spoke up and let them know that what you need to do, right?
Absolutely.
Well, it has been a joy. Every hour that I have spent working for seniors has been a joy. It was not a joy, it was a privilege and a joy.
Yeah.
Well, I'd like to say that I've worked with Ms. Kern on many committees, and I don't know a better advocate for seniors and just looking out for our senior citizens. Yeah. So thank you for everything.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you so much. I enjoyed working with you, too, and I enjoyed seeing you at all the meetings I went to.
Thank you again for your hard work and your passion for our senior citizens.
Oh, how lovely.
In recognition of Willie Mae Daniel Curran, exemplary service to the people of Alamance County, Mrs. Willie Mae Curran has been a proud resident of Alamance County since 1956. Mrs. Curran has a long history of service to this community as an advocator, an educator, and volunteer. Mrs. Curran was appointed to the Alamance County Planning Committee for Services to the Elderly in 1990, and she served faithfully until September 2015. She was appointed the Alamance County NC Senior Citizen Tar Heel Legislature Delegate in 1993. The Alamance County Board of Commissioners doth hereby recognize and honor Willie Mae Curran with her second exemplary services, services honor for her hard work and dedication to the citizens of Alamance County. This 19th day of October 2015 is signed by all of us, the County Commissioners, and we love you and thank you for the hard work.
Well, you are a lovely group of people, and I love you too. And I am so proud of you. And one of the greatest decisions that my husband and I made was to bring our family to Alamance County in 1956. It's been wonderful.
We've enjoyed
every minute of it.
Bless you. Thank you, Ms. Curran.
I think she has some family here too.
Working for other people is that there comes a time when you need it yourself.
That's exactly right. Thank you, man.
I've enjoyed every minute of it. Every minute of it.
You didn't mention the number of young lives this lady touched in her teaching career.
Oh, okay.
So many of
them. I have had a wonderful experience here, and I shall never forget it. And December the 24th, 1922, Santa Claus brought me. My mother said she was delighted that Santa Claus brought me at 10 o'clock in the morning instead of putting me in her stocking. And that was a nice joke in all of our family. I have had a wonderful life, and the privilege of working in a facility like this where you can contribute is at the time that you need it, and you don't go into it ignorantly. Yes. You are so happy that you know about it. And these people in Alamance County have been wonderful, and I have loved every one of them, and I have met so many lovely people. I really have. And I shall cherish you as long as I live. And I support you in everything you do. You're so happy.
Thank you, Ms. Curran.
Ms. Willie Mae, you've got some family today, too, haven't you, with you? Yeah. Your family's with you?
Would you like to introduce your family members?
And it was wonderful to have my family with me. This is my oldest son, John Curran, and his lovely wife, Sarah Neal, and so many other people that I have met. And it's wonderful to be knowledgeable about the people that you are associated with, because you read about them and you appreciate all the work that they do, and you're proud of them. And I'm proud of you. And to be quoted in the paper for something you said as a result of one of the people commenting about it. Thank you, Mr. Smith. You people have been wonderful.
Let me say, Dan, if I may, Ms. Curran, I'm closing in on 20 years with the county, working here and serving. And I'll have to say that during that period of time, you've She scared me to death. every time you spoke, I mean everybody listened.
That's right.
I appreciated that, and I thank you for all of your service. You're just wonderful.
I have been touched by the lives of so many young people who have become such prominent people and such important people and such good citizens of this country. And I love every one of them, and I love you people. And I love all the people that are directing all of these wonderful programs here. I read about it every day. And the senior legislature was wonderful. And I had 21 year, wonderful years there. It was just great.
Thank you.
Very good.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you for having me here tonight. It's really a blessing. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Very good.
This is lovely.
Thank you all.
Thank you, John.
This is just lovely.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
It's been wonderful
being in your presence. And have a wonderful day. Bye-bye, doll.
I've got an outdated one now.
It's been a joy to be here.
Thank you, Mr. Next, we have the consent agenda.
You know what? By serving, when the time comes that you need the service, you at least know at least what to expect. I'm losing my balance. I'm becoming a senior citizen with a lot of problems, and I'm enjoying that too.
Thank you. Right, members, any items on the consent agenda to be withheld from the general action? Hearing none, Mr.
The SOAR award as well.
I'm sorry.
We'll put that in. Yeah.
Yeah, we can go ahead and do that now. That'll be fine. That'll be fine. Quarterly SOAR review, Mr. Honeycutt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And I would like to introduce our library director, MJ Wilkerson, who I believe she was part of the nomination that was for Tampa, but I let her speak to the work that she does.
I am on the nominating committee. We get copies of all the SOAR awards that are submitted, and I have to say, as being on the committee that makes that choice, it's a very difficult choice because there are some phenomenal county employees. The people that work for the county are just an amazing group of people. But I'm very honored that the SOAR award winner for the first quarter is one of my library staff members. Tampa Enoch Reese is heads up the children's department at Mebane Public Library branch, and just does an incredible job. The pictures that were sent in to illustrate the kind of work that she did just this summer included the big puppets, very similar to the ones that Paper Hand Puppets does. I know that she plays the banjo, and I believe is learning other musical instruments. She clogs, so she has found ways to incorporate all these things into her youth services programs. And this is the type of thing that she does on a regular basis. It's not just a once every now and then. She goes above and beyond in preparing her programs and working with her staff to present the highest quality of children's programs that we have. So it was very much an honor when the committee chose her to be the SOAR award winner for this quarter. So, Tampa? I was going to get her here. She doesn't like a lot of recognition, but she's amazing, and she's
congratulations.
Thank you, Pam. Well done. We appreciate it.
And we do have pictures and everything on our website that if you'd like to see as well from the breakfast. And we do appreciate the work that the committee does, but also congratulations to Tampa for the work she does as well.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir. Thank you. All right. Next, we have the consent agenda. Any items to be removed?
Thank you.
I have a motion.
Motion to approve.
Second?
Second.
Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, no. Consent agenda is approved. Next, we have a public hearing. Colon Health Ambulance Services, Mr. Honeycutt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. With respect to a franchise agreement,
under General Statute 153A-250. It has to be approved by the County Board of Commissioners, and basically this would be between us and Cone Health CareLink Division. Basically what they do is paratransit stuff that we can't get to, and specialized services that we can't do, and especially transport between hospital and nursing facilities and things that are above and beyond what our EMS group can do, and especially on a timely basis. So Ben Wooten is here with ARMC. If you want to make any comments, Ben. But Ben used to work for the county, so we promise we still don't hold that against him for leaving.
So. I thought he looked familiar.
We're really glad that he left.
Yeah. Good evening, Commissioners. I'm Ben Wooten. I work in emergency management for Cone Health. I'm based at Alamance Regional. I have Pam Bearden here with CareLink. She's the assistant director, and I'll let her speak a little bit more to what we're going to be doing at Alamance.
Basically, it's to, you know, kind of tag along what you said, it's hopefully to try and keep your 911 service within your county. Right now, unfortunately, because we are staffing out of Greensboro, if we have a STEMI comes into the hospital, and a STEMI is a heart attack that needs to go to the cath lab or have open heart surgery, a lot of times, because we are so far away, your 911 crew is actually leaving the county to bring them to Cone or to Duke, or, you know, there's all other facilities. And we would hopefully be able to help keep your own employees within the county to service the 911 calls here.
All right. Thank you.
And this has been reviewed by our county attorney. We've been working with Cone on this, and also our EMS director, Chuck Gonzalez, is very much in support of this.
And this is for a two-year period, is that what I'm...
I think it was 10?
Yeah.
10 years.
And this requires a public hearing. So, members, I have a motion that we go to into public hearing at this time.
I'll make a motion. We go into public hearing.
Second?
Second.
All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Public has heard what we have heard, at which time we would offer Cone Health Ambulance Services the right to do what they've requested to do, basically. And with that in mind, is there any member of the public on this side that would like to be heard on this matter? Hearing none, is there any member of the public on this side? All right, thank you. Do I have a motion that the public hearing be closed?
So moved.
Second. Motion second. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. All right, Commissioners, any comments before we... Or do I have a motion?
Is there any problem with our EMS on this?
No, sir. We're very much in support of this, and as mentioned, it will free up some of the paratransit stuff that we, not really paratransit, but allow us to have more emergency in 911. It'll free up some units as well.
In reading the contract, it's my understanding that the fees cannot be any more than
right.
what we charge.
Yes, sir.
Also.
Right. Yes, sir.
And that was another. Any other comments?
Well, I might be a little biased, but they provide a great service.
Okay. Well, there you go. We'll let you make a motion.
I'll make a motion that we approve the agreement.
I hear a second.
Second.
All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. All right. Thank you.
All right. Appreciate
thank you for your time.
All right. Next, we have National Friends of the Library Week. Ms. Wilkerson, you're up again.
So National Friends of the Library Week started yesterday, and our Friends Committee is instrumental in supporting the libraries and the things that we do. We couldn't do without them. They hold two book sales a year and donate money to the library that we use for programming. We couldn't do most of our programming efforts without our Friends. And so I wanted to recognize our Friends of the Library group. So we have with us today the president and the vice president, Susan Gann and Jeff Tudor. So we have a proclamation. Thank you.
And I will be glad to read this proclamation with the board's approval. Proclamation National Friends of Libraries Week, October 18th through 24th, 2015. Whereas Friends of Alamance County Public Libraries raise money that enables our library to move from good to great, providing resources for additional programming, purchase of additional materials, support for children's summer reading, and special events throughout the year. Whereas the work of the Friends highlights on an ongoing basis the fact that our library is the cornerstone of the community, providing opportunities for all to engage in the joy of lifelong learning and connect with the thoughts and ideas of others from ages past to the present. Whereas the Friends understand the critical importance of well-funded libraries and advocate to ensure that our libraries get the resources needed to provide a wide variety of services to all ages, including access to print and electronic materials, along with assistance in research, readers advisory, and children's services. Whereas the Friends' gift of their time and commitment to the library sets an example for all in how volunteerism leads to positive civic engagement and the betterment for our community. Now, therefore, be it resolved that Dan Engel, Chair of the Board of Commissioners, on behalf of our commissioners, proclaims October 18th through 24, 2015, as Friends of the Libraries Week in Alamance County, and urges everyone to join the Friends of Alamance County Public Libraries and thank them for all they do to make our libraries and community so much better this 19th day of October 2015. Thank you.
We thank you. Thank you. We appreciate it. Thank you. I'd like to say we have a terrific library director in MJ Wilkerson, and it is our honor to support her and her staff in all that they do and to supplement the good funds that the county allocates toward the library to make our libraries go from good to great. That's what we do, and we would like to invite you to join us in doing that. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Thanks. Appreciate it. All right, next we have item number 2-9 is the resolution e-cigarettes. Ms. Saunders. From the Health Department. Well,
good evening.
Good evening.
E-cigarettes have been increasing in use over the last few years. According to the CDC, adult use rose from 3.3% in 2010 to about 8.5% in 2013. And among North Carolina high school students, the e-cigarette use rose from 1.7% in 2011 to 7.7% in 2013. And with the increase in national and state trends of e-cigarette use, we're beginning to encounter clients using electronic devices in our buildings. In 2001, the Alamance County Board of Commissioners passed a resolution to prohibit smoking within the county buildings, inside those buildings. Fast forward to 2015, and there is some uncertainty as to if the e-cigarettes are included in the smoke-free resolution. So in order to gain some of that clarity and decrease confusion, the Board of Health is asking the current Alamance County Board of Commissioners to review and amend the smoke-free resolution from 2001 to include the language of e-cigarettes in that prohibit. This addition will clearly define that e-cigarettes are included in the smoke-free policy and eliminate the questions regarding enforcement to the resolution when e-cigarettes are encountered in the buildings. And that's the letter of recommendation you have before you. And our county attorney, Clyde Albright, was so kind to propose a resolution that you also have in your packet.
Questions?
Well, I'll say, sitting on the Board of Health representing the commissioners, this subject was thoroughly discussed by the Board of Health, and I mean, I support it. E-cigarettes,
yeah.
What's being vaporized is in part still nicotine.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the
still putting
the
off
main
the
ingredient
same.
Of cigarettes yeah. in them. So I'm concerned about that with the secondhand vapor.
Have you had a lot of issues with that? And kind of enforcement over there?
I can speak to our own personal issues in the health department, and as human services, Susan can speak to theirs as well. But we've had several encounters where folks enter the building and will vape, which is why this came up at the Board of Health, because we have a wonderful sheriff's deputy who serves us at the Human Service Center and is a huge advocate for the staff there, and wanted some clear definition around that so that he could enforce as well, and that we could too, and that any department head could in their buildings.
So the Board of Health is approving this?
They're recommending. So you all have a 2001 resolution that already states the smoke-free policy. Yeah. The Board of Health is asking, and they are endorsing this letter of recommendation, that 2001 resolution, essentially amendment, be made to that includes the e-cigarettes to that smoke-free policy.
Any further questions or comments? Mm-hmm. I have the resolution that was prepared by Mr. Albright here before me, just to give you an idea before I asked if there's a motion. It states this, you need to know what's in it. Has everybody seen it? It was in your packet?
It's in the packet.
Okay, it's in the packet. So yeah, has everybody had a chance to read it? Mm-hmm. Okay, everybody has. So with that being said, I will entertain a motion if there's one at this time.
I'll make the motion that we accept the resolution.
I'll second that.
All right, we have a motion and second. Any further discussion? All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you.
Thank you so much for
Appreciate
your time.
Get your signs.
I want y'all to know I smoked for 25 years.
Oh, that's great. Long time ago.
I never have smoked, and I'm still falling apart.
You don't have something to blame it on now, do you?
I can resemble that remark, Judge. All right, next we have item number 3 of 9, the Planning Committee for Services to the Elderly update. Teresa Jackson with us. Welcome.
Good evening, Chairman Ingalls and Commissioners, County Manager Honeycutt. Nice to see you all. Thank you for your time. My name is Teresa Jackson, and I'm here to represent the Piedmont Triad Regional Council Area Agency on Aging, as well as the Alamance County Planning Committee for Services to the Elderly. As you can see, what we do is very important to all of us who are aging, and hopefully that includes every one of us today and tomorrow too. It's with Ms. Curran leaving, that leaves a huge gap on our committee. And we recognize that we need to reach more older citizens across the county, and we would ask for better representation across the county. We'd like to have all townships represented. And with that said, I would like to acknowledge our chair, Gail Miller, if you would stand, please. And another committee member is here tonight, and this is Nancy, i.e. Foxy Harper. She would stand up. Yeah, she has allowed us to appoint her to the senior Tar Heel legislature as well. So we expect great things from Foxy to take Ms. Curran's place as well. Other members were planning to be here tonight but could not. We have Bob Cleveland from our staff here this evening too, and he works strongly on legislative and advocacy issues. Our committee's bylaws state that the planning committee should have no less than 12 and no more than 21 residents of Alamance County appointed by you commissioners. At present, with Ms. Curran gone and resigning, that leaves us with 8 voting members. So I would implore you to try to seek some knowledgeable folks to represent the county. Individuals can nominate themselves if they would like, and can fill out an application online or get one from me or from the clerk to the board's office. I have given each one of you a copy of the job description to become a voting member. And one of the key roles is to help us all decide what are the key services that are needed for the older citizens of Alamance County. There are home and community-based block grant funds available for in-home services, Meals on Wheels, congregate meals, just all the services that we fund through the federal and state government funding, and we have to establish where those needs can be met and how with the few dollars that we have. As you know, last year our block grant program was cut nearly $1 million, and we spend far more than that through the Medicaid system. So if we can focus on keeping the quality of life for those who can remain home for as long as possible, that's vitally important, and we play a great role in making that determination. Just this year, we had to establish priorities for our funding because it is so limited. And this committee took it to task and decided the top four services were Meals on Wheels, medical transportation that is provided through Alamance County Transportation Agency, and in-home assistance services, vital to keeping folks at home and providing personal care, etc. And the fourth thing was care management of the frail elderly in across the county. So we asked them to rank all of the services. We had a whole list of six other additional services. So all the members of the committee take their role very seriously, and we encourage more involvement in our planning committee, which meets now the third Tuesday at 8:30 at the J.R. Kernodle Center in Burlington. And we, our goal is to have, as we say, you know, if we could get 20 residents and committee members, that would be great. And 51% of the membership should be over 60. And we'd like to have two caregivers represented on the board too. So my challenge to you is to try to talk some of your friends, neighbors, family members, public officials to become involved with our planning committee. And I'd be glad to talk with anyone and explain the positions further. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So you're short how many now? Exactly.
Well, our minimum is supposed to be 12, and so we have eight voting members currently. We've had quite a few that have resigned in the last 2 years. So they, you know, Ms. Curran said it best, you know, you don't know. It's good to be on the committee because then when you get to that point, you know what services are available. But there can be no better advocate than we've had through Ms. Curran for the last 23 plus years. So I challenge somebody to come and, you know, take up her task.
Foxy, you guys fill some big shoes.
Congratulations, Ms.
For a small lady, she had a mighty boy.
If I'm not mistaken, this is the group that, through a planning process 21 years ago, led to the establishment of Alamance Elder Care.
Yes. And they have done wonderful things. They are providing case management, counseling for caregivers, a huge variety of services, along with, we have six funded providers in this county, but they have an array of 10 plus services and reaching many folks. So, thank you.
I had the opportunity to meet with Ms. Miller last week, and she's on the Swepsonville Town Council, and she came up with your help, Ms. Jackson. Y'all worked together and got a new application form, and there was some requirements. It really looked good. I read over it. It looked good. It's a good job.
Can we post that on our website as a
I believe we have in the past.
A board type position.
We do that now.
The application is available online. And for those who can't access computer services, we do have hard copies, and the clerk's office has hard copies as well.
Okay. Any further questions, comments? We thank you, and I'll see you at 8:30 in the morning.
Yes, thank you. Short night.
Yes, ma'am. All right. Moving on to the county manager's report.
Mr. Chairman, nothing to really update at this time.
All right. Commissioners' comments. Anybody want to start? Or no comments?
Move adjournment again.
Well, I just I just wanted to say that we had our first meeting of the task force to look into the mentally ill in our jails. It was a great kickoff meeting, and we're going to be meeting, and Susan and a couple of others of us will be meeting to structure a little bit more structure for our future meetings soon.
And I think
that process is underway.
Yeah, I think everybody had this laying on your thing. This is Cooks for Kids coming up this Saturday, and this is to help with the backpack program for kids in the school that they can eat during the week, but they don't have food in come weekend. And Susan and I are actually going to help out with that, so this should be very interesting. But they actually have some good chefs, too, besides me. Anyhow, it's going to be Saturday at 6 to 8, Elon Community Church. And you probably want to get your tickets, so we'll know how to cook for it. Anyhow, that's it.
Linda, you have anything?
No, I just want to say my mother was a very good advocate when she was leaving.
Judge? Nothing? You've already made a motion on that.
He's already got a motion. I'll second.
All right. Those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Meeting adjourned. Thank you.
Thank you for watching the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building, located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Typically, the first meeting of the month is held at 9 a.m., and the second meeting is held at 7 p.m. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel, beginning at 10 p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching Commissioner meetings online. For technical questions regarding this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of the commissioners' meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information on the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says County Commissioners to visit the commissioners' website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.